Yo. Hey. Boo doo doo doo. Can't touch this. How you doing out there? Did you have a good President's Day? What did we play yesterday for President's Day? Was it good?
Yeah.
Yeah, sure, why not? Yeah.
No, of course it was good. It was we Black, White, or Other. You had me do some singing, karaoke stuff.
Nice.
There was Yacht Rock mix.
Oh, Yacht Rock. Oh, yeah, the Yacht Rock mix. Good mix. It's a fun little Monday. Little day off day. President's Day day. Oh, he's taking days off.
Yeah.
Yes, I am. Fuck you. It's corporate, bro. It's corporate over here. You guys think that you're like listening to like this fucking Footloose and Fancy Free fucking radio station. It is corporate as hell, dude. So if I got to deal with the corporate bullshit, I'm going to take advantage of the fucking corporate perks, and that is getting President's Day off. It's even changed since then. Back in the day, we used to be able to like look at porn at the fucking at the desks, because we'd be booking porn stars and shit. Like, that's part of our show prep. You can't even do that shit anymore.
I still do, but I stand up, sort of give it the, try to shield it with my body.
Good for you. I mean, we do. Look, we get porn chicks on. We gotta fucking look this shit up.
Yeah, the new
show prep, dude.
The intern Jeremy told me that they warned him about sketchy surfing, and there's a log of all this stuff. I was like, don't worry about it.
Sketchy surfing. I mean, you're good with us.
Yeah.
We got 15 years of the grimiest shit possible. We've actually like laid back in my old age. We've calmed down. I wish I could tell you I raged this weekend, but I fucking got sick again. God damn it. I got two vitamin drips, two of them. So hopefully that'll battle it off. I'm going to New Orleans this weekend. NOLA. I'm going to be there for like the very beginning of Mardi Gras. Mardi Gras. Mardi's Gras. I'm going to be there. So, hey, if you see me, walking around tripping balls on acid, fucking holler at me. We got New Orleans listeners, so I might be out. I'll be out in that bitch. Scream at me. And if you're trying to smash and don't live in a bad area, you fucking holler. I'm texting Manny Fresh. I'm gonna be like, oh, is this a good area? If he gives me a thumbs up, I'll go see you. If not, fuck that. I'm staying with friends, so I can't bang at their house. I've had this trip on the books for a minute there. I was supposed to go out there a while ago, but got sick, and I was like, well, fuck it, I'll come out for Mardi Gras. So, it's gonna be fun. I've never been to New Orleans. Just want to tell me there's another street that's like more authentic than where Bourbon Street or whatever fucking Black Zach Morris told me, but I forgot to read what the street was. I'm sure everyone's gonna have some fucking is gonna be in my DMs telling me the cool things to do. 15 best things to do in New Orleans.
You're just literally going for the weekend?
Yeah. Flight's not that long. Saturday and Monday.
Did he say Royal Street?
Maybe that's it. I don't know.
Or Oak Street?
Bro.
Just name them all.
Yeah, sure. The only goddamn fucking... Like I wasn't feeling well, so I just took a break from fucking posting on Instagram, and I went to go like write people back, and it was so many messages. I was like, oh my god, dog, it's all a blur. It's all a fucking blur. I don't remember shit. But yep, New Orleans, I'll be there. I feel like there has been some girls I've been like flirting with on Instagram from New Orleans. So get at me. I'll give it all I got. Today is an interesting show. We got Heidi Pandora. She's hands down. Heidi Pandora, is she here?
Yeah, she's been up front taking photos.
She's hands down probably the most hated guest.
No. Yeah, she is.
She's top five most hated guests here on the All Out show. She came on trying to sell her virginity. Total whore. No one believes that she's a fucking virgin. Total fucking just a sex worker. Like, it's like, you are not, you haven't been a virgin since you were 11. Like, let's be real.
She has that look about her?
Yeah. And she's trying to sell her virginity for $500,000, and she's going to use that money to open up schools in El Salvador.
I still text with her a lot.
Yeah, you text with a lot of girls because you're a fucking simp.
What does that mean?
You're like a bitch. No. You're like a fucking, Bobby friend zone. Like, hey, what's up? No, I'm not doing anything.
That's not what we're talking about.
He did what to you? I can't believe that. You deserve way better than that. You deserve a nice guy. Guy like me. Why are you texting with all these girls that don't fuck you?
Ask her about her plastic surgery, that kind of stuff. Looks like it hurt.
Hey, how's your tit job?
Looks like you broke your nose. Wow.
Man, what a loser, dude.
What?
Why you do that?
I know it through the show. What are you talking about?
Like, why you always texting girls?
Just fucking
text me. Just fucking ignore them.
What would I ignore her for?
Just be like, hit me when you're in town.
Do you realize how... I dated her to fly out here. It takes a little massaging. She wants me to pay for stuff and get her on TV, and I have to sort of sidestep those questions. And
she wants you to pay for shit?
Yeah, I'm like, I can't fucking do that.
Fuck out of here.
I know.
Speaking of pay for shit, we did a we had a GoFundMe for you to for you to have, what's her name, Young Hung Sung? What
you had sex with her?
Yeah, but I don't know her motherfucking...
You don't know her name?
I don't know her goddamn Instagram handle. I don't call her by her fucking Instagram handle. Hung Sung Young.
Hung Young Terrorist.
Hung Young Terrorist. We'll talk about that tomorrow. So basically, I think it was Friday, she came on, and she and I had slept together once. And it just didn't work out. And we had a big to-do about the whole fucking deal. And she is a lady of the night, as they call it.
Doesn't act like one.
And so we raised money to get John some pussy from her. So we'll find out tomorrow how that went.
Mm.
The doesn't sound promising.
No, it doesn't.
Well, if you didn't do it this weekend, you still got tonight, bro. People sent you the money.
I know. Over 400.
Oh my.
intern was stunned. He's like, really?
Yeah, we have our fans of the show. They will pitch in for some good content. So
it's a little different than college radio over here.
It takes a village to raise, you know what I mean? Like, if everybody pitches in, just to fuck it. If everyone pitched in a dollar, like, bam. We can buy John Hookers and have the Hookers rate his ass.
That part sucks.
The rating part?
Yeah, her breaking things down.
Oh, that's going to be awesome.
I don't like any.
She'll be back. She will be back. So that'll be later on this week. Got to figure that out. Today we got Heidi Pandora and got my man Yuli the Monster Diaz. He had a bare knuckle fight, and we'll talk to him.
I can't believe they do that. Bare knuckle. You can fuck somebody up.
Really?
I'm sorry.
Bare knuckle, you can fuck somebody up. Bro, you be saying the most dumb shit sometimes, like obvious as fuck. Water's wet. Like, yeah, motherfucker, yeah. So what you're telling me is bare knuckle fighting is more dangerous than fighting with 10-ounce boxing gloves.
Sure seems that way.
Wow. You should be a sports analyst. Fucking guy. And he's dating a professional wrestler, woman. I don't know if she wants that to be brought up, but she'll be here too. And so it's Heidi, Ulysses. It's going to be a crazy day today. Day's wacky. All right, don't go anywhere. We will be back with Heidi Pandora. And we know you guys hate her, so... Only the most savage calls are getting through. Unless, or you got to be really riding for her. You really got to have her back. I don't want any fucking, no vanilla. It's got to be hot or cold. One of the two. You got to come in hot or you really got to have her back. Because she is mad. Heidi's mad that the stripper that broke her face at the Super Bowl thing, everybody saw that meme where she was on like 15 feet up, fell down off the pole, broke her face, and the lady ended up getting, I don't know, what, probably 40, 50 grand or some shit.
It's around that, yeah. It's over 30, I think.
Yeah. Heidi's mad about it. And she's come to talk about it. All right. It's an all-out show. Do not go anywhere. Shady 45, I'm here with Heidi Pandora. Heidi is famous for, she's going to sell her virginity for how much?
For $500,000.
For $500,000?
Yes.
And then you're going to take that money and build schools in El Salvador?
Yes, I'm going to build schools in my country. You can still do the $40,000 payment a month, though. So we're still good on that.
But no one believes that you're a virgin.
They still, okay, so I came here like a year ago.
Yeah.
Selling my virginity.
Yeah.
But no one offered like not even $1 for my virginity.
I said I'd give you 500 for some head.
I know, but like, come on, Jude.
You could build two schools. You could build two schools in El Salvador for $500.
It's nice to see you again, though. You look really nice. Your hair looks nice, too.
Do you care about children or not?
I do care about children.
Well,
but
I'll just Venmo you some. Right, so, I'll Venmo you some money to get my dick sucked.
I was supposed to be here for Black Friday because I was gonna like give people a discount, but I thought about a new discount though. So if you don't have the $500,000, or if you only have like the $40,000 per month, which you know it's gonna take a long time for you to pay it off, you can do like $250,000, but I will get your sperm injected in me, so I will have the baby as a virgin. So you have.
So they get to pay child support to your fucking ass?
Yes, $250,000.
That's the dumbest shit. I would never want you carrying my child.
It would be a privilege though for your baby mama to have the baby as a virgin. So, like Virgin Mary, you know. But anyways, listen. So I'm here to talk about
That's the dumbest shit I've ever heard.
I'm here to talk about something else too, though.
All right, go ahead.
All right, so you heard about that girl, Jania Sky?
Yeah, you called up. You were all upset about it. Jania Sky was, her video went viral. She fell 15 feet from the pole and busted her old fucking face.
Yeah.
So and then she had a GoFundMe, and people gave her some money.
I'm going to take off my shirt, though, okay?
You going to take off your shirt?
Yeah, because I want to show. Ooh, I actually took off my bra.
Okay.
But listen to me. So basically, I'm calling her up because I think she's scamming people.
Oh, you think she's scamming people,
yeah.
Not you?
So listen, so
the fucking whore that's saying she's a virgin?
Let's start by her GoFundMe account. So she created her GoFundMe account saying, first of all, that her friend created it for her. But you can really tell on her GoFundMe account that she created it herself. Now, her original price was $10,000.
Okay.
Right? Yo,
all
you
right.
like this? It's kind of sexy,
Do
right?
I like what?
My bra.
Yeah.
Listen, so...
Looks like Star Trek shit.
Look at this. You can keep that. So anyway, so she started that GoFundMe account. She started with $10,000. Then she went up to $20,000. She raised $40,000 in less than a week.
Yeah.
And then on top of that, Wendy Williams gave her $10,000 check for her to go to school.
Have you ever thought about maybe busting your face?
All right, so...
To get some money?
Listen to me. I'm a stripper.
Someone already busted your hymen.
I'm a stripper. I climb a 15-feet pole, too. So what is she going to tell me? And you know what? I saw the video on slow motion. She didn't land it straight on her face. She landed first on her knees, and then she put her hand...
Oh, let's watch.
Yeah, look at it in slow motion. She lands on her knees... Then she puts her hands for support.
I don't know, dude. Yeah, that was...
Now, tell me, isn't there something cashy about this girl just sitting down on the side of the stage? Don't you think this was like planned out between
Why
them
Why are you
two?
So hateful?
Listen, she didn't fall on her face
you, I'm
on the
asking,
floor.
I'm asking you,
her
I'm asking, shut up.
Her face
shut
landed
up.
On the
shut
other
up.
Girl's
shut up.
Knee.
It's Ducker. Ducker. Okay. Ducker.
Now,
see what happens?
What happened?
When I ask you a question and you ignore me, we just turn your mic off.
I'm sorry.
Why are you so hateful?
I'm not being hateful.
Why are you hating on her? Let's say she's finessing the situation.
I'm super pumped right now. Listen.
I'm just asking. Let's say she is finessing the situation.
She is finessing the situation.
That's what y'all do. You're a fucking stripper. So, your job is to finesse motherfuckers.
So did you see her interview on the Wendy Williams show? She went on the Wendy Williams show wearing high heels. Oh yeah, so much for your spring ankle, right? Wearing high heels on the Wendy Williams show. What you got to say about that, huh?
Wow. That was it? That's it, Sherlock Holmes?
All right, so listen to me. So I blocked her, unblocked her, follow her, and unfollow her, and I sent her a message on Instagram, and I'm like, how about you donate some of that money to my charity right now? And she didn't respond. So why would she
donate money to your charity?
Because I have a good cause, you know.
How much are you making a month?
I'm making right now $10,000 to $15,000 a month.
All right.
Now, that's another thing, too. She's been dancing since she was 21 years old. Now she's 24. So you're telling me that in 3 years of dancing, if I'm making $10,000 to $50,000 a month, don't you think that she is making more than me?
How much does it cost to build one of your schools in El Salvador?
$100,000. So... Then you're telling me that she doesn't have money saved up in the bank account. She had to go and create a GoFundMe account.
So you could have been putting $5,000 aside, and in 2 years you could have had motherfucking.
No, okay.
You could have already.
My whole
one
point
school.
Is that she's here scamming people, and
people just keep giving her money. You're scamming people.
You know what it is? It's people just want to be followers, and they just want to give her money, and that's it. You know.
Why you're very hateful?
Yo, look what I have under here.
What you're wearing?
I'm also.
You look like a space whore.
Can I show you what
you
I
look
brought?
Like? Fucking like a whore from the future. Like she's got like fucking.
Yo, check out my t-shirt though.
She's got like
Yo,
fucking
check out
like
my motherfucking t-shirt. So
some silver like shiny silver 70s.
Look.
Star Trek fucking bikini on.
It's not a bikini. It's a dance wear. Look.
It's
so
a, it's
I'm
not,
selling
it's
these
a
shirts. $50 a shirt, so
you're
I
selling,
can help. With
you're
my
selling,
donation.
You're selling
yes.
a shirt with your face over the Virgin Mary.
Yes.
And it says
and then,
Santa Pandora.
And then this was inspired by DJ Khaled.
They don't want us to win.
Yeah. They don't want us to win.
Nothing on there is original.
So every t-shirt here is going to cost $50.
How many of those shirts
have
you sold?
It's going to go to my GoFundMe account. So I already raised $400 on my GoFundMe account.
So you sold 8 shirts?
Yeah.
Wow. How many followers do you have?
So you can go on my Instagram, Heidi Pandora, HeidiPandora.
No one believes you're a virgin, dude.
Anyways, listen to me.
Look at me.
Look. Come on. I can't look at you straight in the eyes.
Look at me.
I just can't. I can't do that.
Why not?
So Wendy Williams asked her, right? She was like, they say you broke your teeth, but I see good teeth in there. And then Gia Sky answered that she got chipped on her front of her teeth and that her broken teeth are in the back. Now, what broken teeth are in the back? Those are your moles. You know,
molars.
And all her teeth are fine. The only thing that she got is her teeth chipped. That's it. And then she's talking about she broke a jaw. I did my Google search yesterday about broken jaws. Why are you smirking at me?
Because I've never seen such a hateful, spiteful.
It's not
fucking.
It's
jealous,
not that I'm hating. It's just that
woman.
I'm here to preach the truth. You know, I want everybody to open their eyes about what's going on in our society.
Preach the truth and admit that you're not a fucking virgin.
Look at this.
You're not a virgin. You're not a virgin.
Yes, I am a virgin.
You've had so many dicks in you.
All right, so listen to me. So
dicks for days.
What I'm mad about too.
You probably had 2 miles worth of dicks in
what
you.
What I'm mad about too is that nobody donated $1 to Kobe Bryant's funeral. Like I said last time.
Kobe Bryant is a zillionaire.
All right, so let me tell you something. So
leave Kobe Bryant out of this.
Why are you guys donating money to this girl? Nobody donated money for him.
Because Kobe Bryant.
He has his own foundation. Has anybody donated a dollar to his foundation? No.
I'm sure many people have.
So if he's a billionaire, why he has a GoFundMe account too? I mean, why he has an account too? I'm just saying.
Oh, what account?
But anyways, I'm here to call out Jania Sky. And then her friend messaged me.
It's like I'm talking to somebody with Tourette's or some shit like that. You're all over the fucking place.
Listen, her friend messaged me, Young Pole Master. He messaged me today.
Yeah.
And then he said, I see that you're calling out my friend, Jania Sky. He's like, what, you want to challenge her? So now they're calling me out for a challenge.
So all right. So what is the challenge going to be?
The challenge is going to be a pole dance challenge.
So you versus her in a pole dance challenge?
Yeah. So now you're telling me if she's injured, how's she gonna dance against me?
I thought she's giving up.
She's giving
up dancing.
Now, okay, let's talk about that. Let me tell you something. Okay,
how many dicks have been in you?
Hold on.
How many dicks have been in you?
Okay.
Be real.
No, zero. It's just dildos. Let me tell you something.
You're a fake virgin,
listen,
man.
Can you think about this? Something I'm about to say though. Think about this, okay?
I'm not even gonna break the hymen.
How is she gonna quit the stripping life to become an esthetician? You know how an esthetician, she's gonna make like $40 a day. How is she gonna go from $40 a day to like $500 to $1,000 a night? Think about that. She's just finessing people like you said. How are you going to do that?
You're just mad that she's finessing people better than you are.
No, it's not that. I have a greater cause.
You're using El Salvador as a cause, but you're making a shit ton of money, and you're not putting any money aside for El Salvador.
I'm going to use that money to build a school.
How much money have you put aside for El Salvador?
$400.
$400.
Yes.
Granted, that's like $2 million in El Salvador, but that still ain't shit.
Account. That's on my GoFundMe
But you, account. You're not taking any of your own money.
All right, follow me on Instagram, Heidi Pandora, H-I-D-Y.
You're not taking,
Pandora.
That's my whole point. You said you make 10 to 15 racks a month dancing.
Yes.
And then you probably making some other shit on the side.
All right, so if she's doing so it, why can't I? She has like probably like $250K on her bank account, and she went to go
how
and
you know?
Create a GoFundMe account. Because she's been dancing for 3 years.
How much you got in your bank account?
Okay, and then she,
how
on
much
her
you
Twitter,
got in your
let's
bank
talk
account?
About her Twitter.
I'm asking
she's
you
giving
direct
out her
questions.
Cash App. Why is she giving out her Cash App?
On to top get of
her
free
GoFund-
money.
Exactly. That's exactly my point.
Yeah.
Why is she giving out her Cash App? Why is she giving out her Venmo? Why is she creating a GoFundMe account?
Because she's a fucking stripper that finesses people, just like you.
GoFundMe says directly, do not use this money for your personal interest. She's using this money for her own personal interest.
She'll probably get some new titties and shit. You know what I'm saying? Once she gets her face fixed.
Her face fixed is only her jaw. It's only her teeth. That's it.
That's her face.
And then she never got a sprained ankle. So my whole point here is that she said she got a sprained ankle. She never got a sprained ankle.
I can't believe you flew out here for this.
Yes, I flew. I flew all the way out here just to be hateful, spiteful. It's not hateful, spiteful. It's preaching the truth. So listen to me. So I only came here for one day and
a half. Take your pants off.
All right, let's do it.
All right. I like you better with your pants off.
I am better with my pants off.
All right, she's taking off her pants.
I feel better naked anyway. Yo, can you pull this out? Yo, slowly.
All right, now she's in her bikini. There's no way you're a fucking virgin, dude.
Yo, I just learned how to do that.
She just shook her ass at me. There's no way you're a fucking virgin.
Yo, I feel so much better being like this in the studio.
Yeah, you know why?
Oh my God, like I feel so much
you're
freedom.
A whore.
I feel
That's
like
why.
I have so much freedom.
Yeah. This is what you're used to right here.
Anyway,
talking to
so
men in your drawers.
I want to motivate everybody to go to my GoFundMe account and help me build my school in El Salvador. And I just want to let them know, too, like, just stop.
If you really gave... You came here a year ago.
Yes, I did.
If you really gave a fuck about El Salvador...
So nobody gave me $1. $1 last time I got here from my virginity. Not $1,
because you're not a virgin.
You're not a virgin. Nobody was like, here's $1 for your virginity. No one.
You're not a virgin.
And then this stripper comes out. She falls off 15 feet, which I climb 50 feet, and then they're giving her $40,000.
You're a liar, dude. You're lying on your pussy, dude.
No,
everyone
I'm
knows
not.
You're not a virgin.
No, I'm not.
You can probably take all the
I went to pee like 3 times before coming here to the studio. My vagina is getting tighter by the second. Just letting you know right now.
Just because your pussy's tight don't mean that you're not a virgin.
Even when John went to find me, I was like, yo, can I go to the bathroom for the last time? I couldn't help it. My vagina is getting tighter by the second.
You get finger fucked?
No. I'm telling you.
That
I'm
was
using,
a lot. You, did you hear that shit? You heard that shit. Now.
Now.
you already, you weren't even ready. Just, why don't you stop with this?
All right, so what are we going to do about the situation, though, about Jania Sky? What are we going to do?
What are we going to do?
Yeah, what are we going to do about this? How can we stop this? How can we? It's like a virus going on right now. You know, everybody's like posting, reposting stuff about her and supporting her and everything.
Why are you
like,
so mad? And
the original video on her Instagram account, you can see that she's not genuinely crying. She's like forcing herself to cry. She's like making like sounds with her nostrils.
All right, I'm going to let
like
the callers at you.
Cocaine.
All right, I'm going to let the callers
she's
at
like,
you.
She's like, I didn't plan to do this, but thank you everybody who's been supporting me. How genuine is that? And she was moving her jaw up and down. She was clearly speaking after the fell. And how do you dance, fall? I mean, how do you dance on a pole, fall from the pole, and then keep twerking after 1 second of falling?
It's called heart.
Nah. So
it's heart.
No. It was
called heart.
It was planned out with her and that girl who sat on the side of the stage. It was already planned out because she fell on her knees. She didn't fall on her face. She fell on her knees.
That's the dumbest shit I've ever heard.
Watch the video in slow motion.
You saying you were a virgin.
Watch the video in slow motion. Slow motion for me, baby. Slow motion for me.
You ain't been a virgin since she was like 10.
Yo, put that.
Your cousin fucked you.
Yo, put that song Clout. I wanna sing the lyrics.
We're not putting none of. Wait, you're gonna sing along to a rap song?
Yeah, it's straight from the street to Penthouse, Miami Beach.
Oh my God, dude! All right, 888-742-3345. Corey in the D.
What up? That bitch needs to take some money and go get a face transplant. Nobody gives a fuck about her school. All she's doing is running her mouth about some chick she's jealous about. Get a hobby. And
I do have a hobby.
Don't say that you're a virgin.
Have you seen how I pole dance?
Your face has been fucked more than a gay man's butthole. Come on. Give me a break.
Give yourself a break,
buddy.
Yo, go on my GoFundMe account. Donate me $10 at least for calling here.
I'm disgusted. I can't imagine making more than $7.50 a night.
What, $7.50 a night? Yo, what you mean? I made about $500 to $1,000 a night.
You make minimum wage.
You just hate it because you can't buy my virginity. That's all you hate about.
You know why he can't buy your virginity? Because
you're just hating. You're just hating because you had a baby.
Duck her fucking mic, dog. Duck her mic, dog.
You couldn't give me money to fuck you.
You know why he can't buy your virginity? Because it's been gone for the last 27 years. That virginity left when your dad went out to get a pack of smokes.
Like donkey shows now.
Wait, you found your dad?
I found my dad.
You found your dad? Where
yeah,
was he?
The donkey show.
No, my dad was somewhere in Mexico hiding from everybody, hiding from his 15 children.
Yeah, because fucking doing donkey shows. It was your fifth or sixth donkey show. That's where you found your dad at. Yo. Probably a family donkey. He was probably fucking a sheep.
What do you mean fucking a sheep?
Let's go to George.
Thank you, Corey.
Let's go to George.
Yo, so many people hating on me right now.
Yo, Ivy, stop lying. You're not a virgin, bitch. I've been following you for a whole year. You were fucking the motherfucking supermodel Salvador. Bitch, you're trying to make money. You moved from a raggedy-ass apartment to another raggedy-ass apartment. You always on the fucking pole. You have no motherfucking ass. You out there... I don't know who the fuck pays you, but you're hating on the next stripper.
Bitch, get an ass first.
Bitch, you do not have an ass, bitch. Bitch, si puta, callate vos, hija de puta. Callate, cerota.
Hey, okay, this is somebody that knows me personally. Who's this? Who's this hating on me?
Well, just because he knows Spanish, he knows you personally? We got a lot of fucking people that know Spanish that listen to this show.
Bitch, I do not know you, bitch, but I know you from El Salvador, so I kicked it with your people. Si puta, mal nacida, hija de puta.
That's it, Jew.
That's all I gotta say to that bitch.
Wait, what does that mean?
Are you gonna buy one of my Santa Pandora shirts?
She's still trying to sell a shirt.
I'm not buying shit from you, bitch. I'm not buying shit.
Yo, can I ask you a question?
If anything, I'm gonna give the money to the other bitch.
Yeah. What? You're gonna give money to the other girl? Why are you not gonna? Okay, so you're Salvadorian. Okay. No.
Come mierda.
Come
mierda,
cerota. So you're gonna give money to this girl?
I don't know what that means, but it sounds really bad.
Country? So this guy's gonna donate for her, but you're not gonna donate for your own country? What kind of Salvadorian are you? What kind of Salvadorian are you?
I'm a real motherfucking Salvadorian. I know when the bitch is trying to play me. You're trying to play somebody.
You are. You're trying to play.
You're not a virgin.
Why don't you sell pupusas?
That bitch has more. Hey, that bitch has more miles than my motherfucking semi. You have so much adrenaline in you.
I bet you touched your dick thinking about me. When was the last time you touched your dick thinking about me?
Man, just duck her fucking mic, please.
Get that bitch out of there, Jew. You losing ratings on this.
There's a gang of motherfuckers just want to yell at you.
Yo, all right. How do you make oatmeal though?
I just had some.
What's the proper way to make oatmeal? Yo, so...
What's the problem?
Now, listen to me. Listen to me. So, this guy is saying that he's going to donate
Nelly
to
in Maryland. Go ahead, Nelly.
Oh, my God. Nelly, the singer.
What up, man? Hey, I'm going to, man. You are a fucking bird, man. You're giving us a bad fucking name out there, man. You sound awful on this fucking radio. You look like one of them, the little Vietnam fucking girl boys and shit. You look like you'd be good over there type shit. You know what I mean?
He says that you look like a lady boy.
It's okay.
Yeah, lady boy.
You think these titties look like a lady boy titties? No. You think his ass look like a lady boy's ass? You think this pussy looks like a lady pussy boy's pussy
ass?
You
look exactly like a lady boy.
Let me see your pussy.
Show you my pussy hair, dude. You have to pay like $10,000 just to see it. Okay, can I ask you a question though? Why are you hating so much on me? For what?
It's not even the fact that I'm hating. It's the fact that you sound dumb as fuck on the radio and you make a Salvadorian sound dumb as fuck.
Nelly, let me tell you something. I don't think anybody even equates her to any Salvadorian whatsoever. If anything, she's...
I appreciate that.
Yeah, I'm not going to be like, I fucking hate Salvadorians because Heidi's ass. I don't... She's something special. If anything...
I am real special.
You a fucking... You a goddamn...
She a fucking bird.
You a poverty hustler, too. You a slum hustler. You trying to use the poverty of fucking El Salvador to make some money.
Yeah.
That's some fuck shit.
All right, so this girl, listen. So this girl said that she got a broken teeth, broken jaw, and broken ankle.
You just keep going over the side. Are those new titties since last time?
Oh my God, these are the same ones that I had last year.
How much some titties cost you? I'm asking you how much some titties cost.
That's another thing too. Why she didn't go to Colombia for her surgery?
Why don't you shut the fuck up and answer the question? How much some titties cost?
$2,000 in Colombia.
$2,000 in Colombia.
Yes.
That's so, kindergarten. That's you could open a kindergarten class. You could have opened a preschool in El Salvador.
Nah. If her surgery cost $40,000,
you could have taught them the alphabet in El Salvador with them titties.
Yo, holla at Eminem. But listen to me. So, if why she couldn't go to Colombia to get her surgery? I bet you her surgery in Colombia would have been like $5,000.
Chris in Cincinnati, Chris.
She is super genuine, isn't she?
Man, I gotta address this bribe. She is the most high definition of bitches hating on other bitches. I'm not speaking to you. I'm talking to you, and I'm talking about you straight to you. You ain't shit. Let me just put that out there. First of all, you ain't shit. Right. You're out here buying titties. You're out here sliding down a pole talking about you want people to fucking support you in El Salvador to build your fucking school. Why don't you build some motherfucking character, you hating ass trick? You the hating ass trick. And it's bitches like you that make other motherfucking women like me that want to slide your punk ass. Leave that girl alone. Worry about you.
Yo, contact Dr. Phil.
Why don't you try that? Worry about you. You in the motherfucking studio stripping down to your goddamn panties.
So what? What's wrong with that?
You the stinking ass. You the stinking trick ass bitch.
You hate on my body?
Hate.
Yeah.
Bitch, you probably ain't even got no motherfucking body. Tell you out here begging for motherfucking followers.
Like. How much
Why
you make
don't
a
you
week?
Get your motherfucking self together. Worry about you and leave that girl alone.
I make more than you in a month that you make in 6 months.
I doubt it.
Yes.
I don't sell pussy, bitch.
Yo, hey.
I don't sell pussy. Either. I don't need to. You feel what I'm saying?
Hey, look.
Ben strong.
Look, all that money you make in El Salvador ain't seeing none of it.
Can I tell you something?
El Salvador ain't seeing none of that money. All that money you bragging on, El Salvador ain't seeing none of it.
Can I tell you something, though? There's a difference between a stripper and a professional. And I'm a real professional.
So, yeah, professionals fuck for money.
No, I don't do that. I don't do none of that. Yo, you like my outfit, though? It's kind of sexy.
No, I told you look like a bootleg Star Trek fucking misfit.
Wait, haven't you noticed my body got so much better? Yo, I can do a handstand now.
You can do a handstand. Go ahead. Why the fuck not?
Heidi
Pandora's
do
fun. I don't give a fuck. All just right, as long as you do it silently.
Wait, how do I do it? You have to get me.
I gotta get you. I thought you can do your own handstand. Hey, maybe you'll bust your face and you can make some money. Heidi Pandora's just in here doing handstands. And now she's doing
the
splits.
Check this out.
You're blocking the camera view, man.
Yo, sorry. How is that? How is that for a handstand?
That was cool if you're into handstands.
You should have brought a stripping pole so I can show you everything that I do here.
There's a light. There's that pole over there with a light on it.
I can definitely climb that.
No. Oh my God, you'll crash that bitch.
Oh, and then I have my
Heidi,
own GoFundMe
what's it like
account.
To be the. You are single handedly the most hated regular guest.
They were going
to
say the most beautiful. Yo, play that song, though. Clout. Everything you should do for clout. Everything you should do for clout. Yo, play that song, Clout.
Not one person has your back. Not one fucking person.
All right.
Yo, Alex from North Carolina.
Yo, let me get on the lyrics, though.
Hey.
Yeah, go ahead.
Hey, listen. You got a freaking Colombian boobies. You got a fake Floridian butt. You got an El Salvadorian attitude. I'll tell you what. I'm freaking one click away from donating $1,000.
Yeah.
To GoFundMe.
I love
one
you.
Click away.
I love
one
you.
One click away. You show Jude the cookie, and I will click right now.
Are you serious? Right now?
I'm one click away.
All
one
right.
click.
All right, one click away. Yo, Jude, check this out.
I don't want to see her pussy.
Jude, can you just say that?
Nah, I'm going to shut my eyes.
Jude,
you don't get $1,000. I don't want to see your pussy.
One
fuck your pussy.
One click away.
No. Nope.
One click away.
Nah.
That's like less than a second. That's like 0.5.
That's just
going to
look like a sick-ass clam. I don't want to see that shit.
One click away.
Jude, look.
No, I don't want to see it. I don't want to see your fucking weird ass pussy.
I'm going to stop talking the way I talk. I'm gonna change my voice to sexy voice. Jude.
That's your sexy? You sound like a tranny.
You sound like a tranny
trying to finesse a dude. You're going to jump him
like
in a hotel.
Trying to sell churros. What the hell is that?
I'm not a tranny. Look. This is my sexy voice. Jude.
Oh my God,
Jude,
Jesus Christ.
Look at my pussy, Jude.
Show it to
Yo,
Chris.
Imagine that was your alarm.
Right.
Oh, okay, one click away. I'm about to show
right, let
it.
Me
Ready,
see.
Set.
Yep. Boop. She ain't show shit.
I show him. Yeah. You saw them lips, though?
She ain't show shit.
It's getting tighter by the second.
What her motherfucking Flash Gordon
Yo,
bikini
that's going to be
on.
Your alarm clock. Jude, Flash. Let me show you my pussy, Jude. Whoa. Jude. Yo, I got singing skills.
You're all fake. You're bullshit. You are faker than freaking. You're faker than a ficus in a 78-year-old woman's house, dude. You are fake. You dirty fake fart bag. I hate you.
Fart bag? Fart bag? How are you calling me a fart bag?
Well, it's not how. Have you seen... It's why.
Yo, go follow
why
me
would be the question? Why?
Yo, go follow me on Instagram, Heidi Pandora. H-I-D-Y Pandora.
I don't even want to even fluctuate with your plugs, your shameless
What's fluctuate?
Plugs. You devil insinuating hoochie mama fart bag.
Yo,
dude,
why am I the most hated person on SiriusXM right now?
You are a swamp donkey dirt squirrel. You are a swamp donkey dirt squirrel. I bet when you go into the forest, the animal go, oh my God, what does that smell? And then they just run. They just run.
Can you stop? Hey, can I tell you something though? My birthday's February 22nd.
What's that got to do with anything?
Guess who doesn't care at all? Me. Yo. Me in my truck. I don't care.
My birthday's February 22nd. Come to my birthday
party. You know
what
my birthday is?
When?
Hey, what's your name?
My zodiac sign is Pisces.
It doesn't matter what your name is. Nobody gives a shit.
Hey, come to my birthday party, though.
You know what?
I'm celebrating Miami.
I don't want to smell horribly cooked Alva Salvadorian food. All
yo,
right? So all right. I'm saying the hell
yo, so when, what's up? When, like, when and where's your when and
so
where's your
I'm gonna
birthday
get
party?
Baptized. I'm getting baptized.
Wait, all right, so
I'm getting baptized for my birthday.
Where is it going to be at, though?
Yo.
I don't give a fuck.
Yo!
Chris, man, stop playing, bro.
You gotta be playing, okay?
Stop playing, man. Let her fucking plug her goddamn birthday party. How old are you going to be, 42?
42?
How old are you going to be?
I look like I'm 21.
I don't give a fuck.
Yo, stop. Yo.
All right, hold up, man. I want to stick around. Let's go to music. I'm going to bring Yuli in here.
Can we do the clout song, though?
The clout song?
Yeah.
I'm gonna bring my man Yuli Diaz in here. He just won a bare knuckle fist fight. I'm going to have y'all two on at the same time. Then you can leave.
He's going to fist fight?
He won a fist fight.
Who?
My man Yuli.
He want to fist fight me? He want to fist me? Fist fight, like fist fight, fist fight.
Yo, I'm starting to understand why your dad left.
Yo, but I found him, though.
I'm starting to understand.
Yo, can we do a song for Cloud, though? I want to rap. Ooh, oh, shit. Wait, you got to play from the beginning, though. Yo, I'm lost. Play from the beginning.
Oh, my God.
Do anything for Cloud. Do anything for clout.
Yeah, you
do
will.
Do anything for
yeah,
clout.
You
ready
will.
To go. Yo. Heidi Remix. Yo. Hey. Skirt. Ready. Yo. 1, 2, 3, go. Straight up Bain House, Miami Beach. Niggas are Twitter on Twitch. They don't want cause I can tell them feet. I peep these niggas all sweet. Bamboo sticks on the sheep. It's a new weirdo every week. Get a whip, put in seats. No secure IG disease. Him for clout.
That's
doing
dope.
Doing them for clout.
Now do it on
doing
beat.
Doing them for clout. Yo.
Right,
mad
bro.
Talented up in this beat.
Yeah, you got it,
yo,
man.
Yo, that guy told me to find a hobby. Yo, I already know what my hobby is.
Butchering songs.
I'm a rapper.
Yeah. I want to holler my man, Yuli.
Yo, you imagine that if I make a remix to that song? Yo, straight to the penthouse, Miami Beach. They hating because I'll be on tweets. It's a new weirdo every week. Yo, let's hit it on my IG.
Don't care. All right, Yuli Diaz is coming up.
Oh boy!
I'll let Yuli talk to you for a second, and then
what's Yuli?
Yuli, man, Yuli.
Yo, so DJ Pauly D was here last month, huh?
You just yell just random shit, bro. You just
Yo, just, because I've been messaging him on Instagram. He never writes back.
Just play some music, please, dog. Like, cause
yo, straight up from Miami Beach. Niggas hit me on Twitch.
Shay 45, we are back. Today's kind of a wild show. We usually don't, like, cross guests over. But we had Heidi Pandora on. She is still here. Heidi?
What's up? I'm still here. Super pumped up right now.
She's extra pumped up. She is selling her virginity.
For $500,000.
$500,000.
Yes.
And she's going to take that money and build schools for people in El Salvador.
For El Salvador. Children in El Salvador.
But no one believes that you're a virgin.
No, but I already raised $400 on my GoFundMe account. So you can go to my GoFundMe account and then help me out so I can build my school.
You're at $400 or $400,000?
$400.
Okay.
On my GoFundMe account.
She got a ways away.
I'm trying to work with the president in my country, you know?
It's hard to sell your virginity when you're a whore.
I'm not a whore. I'm not a whore. I've never had sex before in my life. He just dropped his coffee just like that.
Yeah.
With a person or?
What do you mean? I've had it with a dildo before, but never with a person.
Well, that counts, though. You broke the hymen. The hymen's done.
I don't know what a hymen is.
You better put some ketchup packets in your fucking pussy.
Ketchup packages?
Yeah.
What? It's going to make it look like a period or something.
Yeah, that's what it looks like.
Oh,
when
I didn't get the joke.
Yeah.
It's like the heirs, right? When they have sex for the first time and they like need to prove themselves that they're a virgin.
They bring out the
But don't you think my idea is better to just have a baby as a virgin, though? So I can be like the next Virgin Mary.
I don't think anybody. Yeah, she wants to take someone's sperm and shoot it inside of herself.
Yeah, so then I can just have the baby as a virgin.
The turkey baster. Oh.
Yeah,
but you want $500,000.
No, so if I get the sperm injected in me, then I don't have to like get the $500,000. I can just do $250,000.
And this is a discount.
Yeah,
this
it's a discount.
Oh. This Dana Brooke, by the way.
I had this discount for Black Friday, but Black Friday is already gone. So.
But it's still sticking around.
It's still sticking around.
I can't believe no one took you up on you mothering their child.
Not even Salvadorians have reached out to me. But still, you know, I'm going to keep my faith.
Well, you said they're pretty poor down
there. All you need is faith in life. That's it.
So I'm guessing you're from El Salvador.
Yeah, I'm Salvadorian and Mexican.
All right.
So, I'm supporting my country.
Okay, okay.
Yo, just go to my GoFundMe account.
Yeah, she's making all this money every month that doesn't see El Salvador, doesn't see any of that money. But
money you're making going?
She'll be happy to take your money and give it to fucking El Salvador.
Well, it's like that girl, Jania Sky, right? She had $250,000 in her bank account, but she made a GoFundMe account. She already raised like $30,000, right?
Why are you so jealous?
It's still the same thing, right? She has money. Why is she making a GoFundMe account?
You.
So it's the same scenario.
You down in Miami and stuff. What's?
I'm wondering if El Salvador is somebody's nickname or is it the country.
Oh, you are so funny, so funny. Yo, that voice is sexier though, right?
What, your voice?
Yeah, like this.
Yeah, keep doing it like that.
That shit probably turns you on.
You know what turned me on?
What?
If you left.
What, dude? Come on now. You know I love you. Hey, yo, we're friends, right?
I know, but like, look, I was trying to...
Yo, I really like that hairdo, though. Where'd you get that hairdo done? Because that's pretty nice. It's pretty sharp.
Thank you, I appreciate
it. It's like somebody licked it off or something. It looks pretty nice.
I actually did. It was licked by a young El Salvadorian.
Yo, you like how I did that with my tongue, though?
Let me see how you... Yeah, you ain't no virgin flicking their tongue the way you flicking that motherfucker. Have you
that's
fucked a chick?
That was my next question.
Have you fucked a girl?
Yes, I have, but I'm still a virgin. It doesn't count. You know what I mean? Because that's just like rubbing pussy on each other. There's no penetration at all.
Yeah, but you use dildo.
Nah, I didn't put a scissor inside her.
You didn't put a scissor inside of
you
her?
You just asked me.
No.
Scissoring is like a sex move.
Oh, I don't know. Oh, I didn't know that. You see? I'm still innocent.
All right.
You ate some pussy, though?
Yo, so let's go back onto the girl, Jania Sky, though.
Are you working at a club? Or
yeah, I work at a strip club. I'm like one of like the best performers at the club.
Where's the club?
Huh? I work at Empire in Washington, D.C.
Oh.
Yeah, so I climb a 15-foot pole and I just do the drop, boop, just drop myself, you know? Pop, like a rock star. Because that's what I am. Yo, straight to Penthouse, Miami Beach. They see me on tweets. They don't want it because you know every week.
Oh, she's a rapper too.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, you didn't hear that?
Yeah. I heard three words that rhyme there.
Yeah, Yuli. Fuck
yeah. Making the remix to that song.
All right.
Yo, so for my birthday, I'm getting baptized, though.
When is your birthday?
My birthday is February 22nd. I'm going to get baptized.
Oh, you're a Pisces.
Yes. Pisces. How'd you know that? You're a Pisces too? Gang. Oh, you see? That's why we're connecting, though. Listen to me. So he knows what I'm talking about. So I'm getting baptized for my birthday.
Yeah, that's what Pisces do.
So I want to invite everybody.
I think you're mixing up the words.
I want everybody
baptism
to come to my.
Or bukkake.
But I don't know what bukkake is. It sounds
I'll
like Bugatti.
Yeah.
It sounds like Bugatti. Is it Bugatti?
Yeah, it's totally like that. We'll show you later.
So I want to invite everybody to fly out to Baltimore, Maryland and come see me getting baptized. I still haven't found the church yet.
I don't give a fuck.
Come on, dude.
No one cares.
Come on, dude. Don't you want to see me go into that holy water?
Hey, boy.
I'm trying to help the Salvadorian kids. I offered you $500. I was going to give you $500 for some head. I don't even need to come. You know what I mean?
What do you mean? But I don't even know how to do it, though.
You don't know how to give head?
Yo, play that. When he said something, play that. So he knows what it feels like. I don't give a fuck. Hey.
Why would he do that to me?
Hey, strip to a penthouse,
that would be
Miami
stupid.
Beach. Listen to me. So you coming to my baptism or what?
No. Heidi, it's been nice having you.
All right, nice having you, too.
You're
going to kiss me this time or what?
I see you
blushing.
They said I kissed you last time, and I had blocked it out of my memory.
Oh, I thought you blocked out when I kissed you, you know?
Yeah.
It was so good that you blocked out.
I don't think you want to kiss me. I got coffee breath, so.
Okay, anyways. All right, June. I love you so much.
I love you, too. Heidi, good luck.
With my GoFundMe account?
Yeah, selling your fake ass virginity.
Yo, I'll be back next year and you're gonna see how much I have improvised in life.
She got her virginity in China.
Made in China.
How much you've improvised in life?
Yes.
You mean improve?
Yo, maybe I should get a Chinese guy to lose my virginity with, because then I'm not gonna feel anything. Think about it. That shit's not gonna hurt. Because I'm really scared that's gonna hurt. You know what I mean?
How big are the dildos that you've taken?
Whoa, they're fucking huge.
Well, then I'm sure you're straight.
Yeah, they're fucking huge.
You got practice.
I like the purple dildos, though, for some reason. That color, that beautiful color, purple. Big purple.
Yeah.
Pretty nice.
Barney dick.
Yep. Dinosaur dick.
Fucking purple rain. Go ahead.
All right, thank you, Heidi. All right, I love you so much, dude.
Where can people follow you?
Yo, follow me on Instagram, Heidi Pandora, H-E-I-D-Y, Pandora, P-A-N-D-O-R-A. And if you want to come see my full show, I work at Empire in Washington, D.C., so you can just come and watch me do the drop.
Are you going to be dancing here at all?
Yo, and I'm going to make that remix to that song, too, Clout.
We'll do Hate or Love It with that.
What?
We'll do Hate It or Love It. We'll play it, and people can call up and say whether they like
it. All right, sounds good. I'll send you my mixtape. I'm going to do it with him. Who sings it in again?
I don't know, dude.
Oh, all right. I got you, June. I love you.
Someone from Migos, I guess.
Oh, yeah. All right. I got you. We good? We good in the hood? We good?
Have you ever been butt fucked?
Yo, so I just came here just for 1.5 days. It's fucking amazing. I landed here yesterday and I'm here now. Yo, look, you have me right in front of you.
Do you know how many cans of tuna you could have bought for the kids in fucking El Salvador with that money?
Dude, but I'm trying to get people to support me, you know?
How
to
many,
support about my dreams and goals.
How many coloring
in life.
Books you could have bought El Salvadorian 4-year-olds?
So that's my first thing. That's my first thing. I'm going to donate to the school where I went to when I was little. And then after that, I'm going to build my own school.
If I was you, I'd burn that school down because you dumb as hell.
Come on, Jude.
That school ain't doing you no favors.
I represented their school. I was in like all pageants and everything. I represented their school. I'm going to become the principal of the school.
Yo,
imagine having your kids in my school where I'm the principal. Yo, holla if you have a dollar.
Would you wear the bikini and shit?
Hell yeah. They should teach pole dancing in school, as a matter of fact.
That way, kids.
Yo, I'm making as much as a doctor and a lawyer right now, and I don't even have a degree. So imagine that.
What do you make a year?
A year, like 100K? More than 100K? KKK? I mean, never mind, I shouldn't have said that.
Say whatever you want. I don't think you can say anything that's going to piss people off anymore.
Yeah, I know. I'm like the most hated person right now.
You are the most hated person.
I don't know why, yo. I need to get somebody to at least like show me some love, at least from my own country, you know? Everybody who's been calling has been like blasting me out for some reason. Kind of hurts my feelings.
Because you're hateful and ignorant, you know, and you're lying.
I'm a stripper, but I'm still a person.
Yuli.
Oh, that's Yuli?
Yeah, this is Yuli.
Oh.
Yeah, Yuli. Yuli.
They've been mentioning you for a while. I was like, who's Yuli?
The one and only.
One and only Yuli. Yeah. Okay. Yo, you saw that voice
and
he
this
did?
Is, yeah, and this
pretty
is...
pretty sexy.
His special lady friend, Dana.
Dana, nice to meet you. You do wrestling too? Oh, you guys do the fist... What is it, fist pumping?
I don't know. What's fist pumping?
You told me earlier that they do fist pumping.
No, I was saying he was doing bare knuckle fighting. He was
bare fist knuckle fighting.
Yeah.
Oh, I mixed it with fist pumping.
You ever been fisted, Heidi?
I don't know.
You first said, thing that came on my mind too.
All man. I remember is you said something fist something.
Dana, yeah. how could we get Heidi into wrestling so I could just watch her get beat up?
I already know how to fight.
Yeah, but like not wrestling.
All right, so what? I already know how to do that. Yo, I'm Salvadorian, it's in my blood.
What do you know how to do?
I know how to wrestle. I can drop you down to the floor. Let me do it right now. Like, come here.
I'm good.
Stand up, though.
I'm good.
Can I do it to you, though?
Come on, let's try this.
Yo, all right, man, that's between y'all.
Let me show him how you drop someone to the ground.
Don't hit nobody too. Oh my God, dog. Alright, so Heidi's gonna fucking.
Yo, yeah, he's met on everything.
Alright, so Heidi's gonna. Alright, so Heidi's got.
Look, you do this, right?
And then she tried to trip him, and he just stood there.
I could have dropped. No, you have to make
bro,
your
she just did some shit you learned in pre-K.
Yo, I almost dropped him though, but he had to flex on himself.
Ladies and gentlemen, she didn't get close to dropping me, but
nah, that was.
You want me to do it to you?
She got as close to dropping me as she's as close to those 500,000.
Yo, you saw that? It was like a back kick and whoop, go to the floor.
Dog, that was really some second grader shit, dog. For real. That was a cunt hair away from like when someone bends down behind you and the other person pushes you.
Yeah. Yo, it's like a foot trick. You know about that trick, don't you?
I know exactly. Yeah.
You learned that shit in El Salvador.
I'm gonna use it on my next fight.
You see? Learning something from me.
There you go.
Knowledge is power. Knowledge is power. Straight to Penthouse, Miami Beach.
We need to get you some power.
Dana, you can use that in your next wrestling.
I was just going to say, check it out Friday.
Yeah.
I might have it in there.
Put that fit in the back and just crack.
You might see that move on SmackDown.
Yes.
I'll give you a shout out.
Yo, thank you so much. Appreciate that.
Yeah. Heidi, I hope you...
Yo, learn from a pro.
You got to come up with a new hustle because no one believes that you're a virgin.
Well, no, I'm not quitting on myself, first of all.
Why don't you just sell some pussy? Just sell pussy.
This is who I am. This is who I am as a human being, you know? I was going to wait sex till marriage, but I don't believe in marriage, so I might as well sell it. I think people are just mad, you know? They're just mad. They're having babies like, well, they're not virgins nowadays. Are you looking at me or are you looking at the paper? I can't even tell.
I'm just watching you lie. I'm just watching a fucking liar. Just
all right. So follow me on Instagram, Heidi Pandora, H-E-I-D-Y Pandora.
All right,
and then follow Rude Jude too on All Out Show.
All right,
yo,
man.
I just gave you a holla. Holla for a dollar.
Man, just turn off her mic. Just turn off her mic. Thank you. Escort her out. Thank you. Thank you, Heidi. Show your boobs. Show your tits. Show your tits. Show your tits or else we're going to keep your mic off. Show your tits or we're keeping the mic off. All right, they're done. Bye. See ya.
Can't hear you with your shirt on.
Okay, she showed her boobs. All right, go ahead. What else?
Yo, get ready for the new teachers coming up soon. It's going to be hashtag. Listen, wait. It's going to be hashtag super pumped up right now.
Cut her mic off.
No.
Show your boobs again or else. All right, finish.
Okay, one more thing. I'm going to say it again. But don't cut me out, please. Don't.
I don't know.
My new teacher's coming out soon. Yeah. Super pumped up right now. I want everybody to wear them, represent them, super pumped up right now. If you're super pumped up right now, you're just going to wear up this T-shirt.
All right, what's the website?
What's the website?
Or
what?
Where do they go to get your shirts?
So they're coming.
I don't give a fuck.
Heidi, you're the best.
Oh, boy. Nigga, I'll be playing, okay? Oh, boy.
You're the most hated, but you're number one in my heart, Heidi.
Aww,
all right, let me play one song and we'll come back with Yuli and Dana Brooke. All right, Heidi, let's take this picture, and I'll come back and talk some shit. Shay 45, I got Yuli the Monster Diaz and Dana Brooke
What's
up in this.
Up?
Are y'all dating? Or just, are you guys buddies? Or
we're in a beautiful relationship right now.
That's fucking awesome.
Thank you.
That's fucking
flourishing, you know?
Yeah.
How long y'all been talking for?
About 2 months now.
Oh, no shit.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So you got to go watch the bare knuckle fight.
Of course. It was absolutely amazing. Something that I've never seen before. It takes one strong, I would say, mental strength of a person to even step foot in that circle. It's not like a squared circle, mm-hmm. It's a circle.
For
yeah.
real.
Yeah.
Can you pull up the footage, Jonathan?
So I, working
so
on
I
it.
Can so I can see so I can see. So break it down. It's
Yeah,
it's a circle.
The ring is a circle.
Okay.
You start 3 feet from each other. The line says toe the line. So this guy's 3 feet away from you. And once the referee says knuckle up, it's time for action. And them fights end quick.
Shit.
Yeah, actually this time around, those 3 fights that went the distance, and they were all tough motherfuckers, every single one of them. And but one hit, that was a good one right there.
Thank you.
One hit, people getting cut, people getting knocked out, sleep. Like these fights are hectic.
How many people do they line? How many people are on the card since the fights go so quick?
This one was 9 fights, so
okay.
Yeah, 18 fighters, yeah. Yeah.
And how long did that last?
It was quick.
For real?
Yeah, this was a quick. Minute and 13 seconds.
Yeah, mine was a minute and 13
in and
seconds.
Out.
Well, another couple dudes had first round knockouts. The fight right before me, it was two light dudes. They would fight at 135.
And yeah.
One guy went to sleep. He don't even remember even fighting. Tough motherfucker, though. I seen him fight a couple times.
Right.
He's a bad dude, but, you know, he got caught, and that's what happens in the game, you know?
Yeah.
He got caught. He died on his sword, though, so, you know, you got to get it to him.
Yeah, you get carried out on your shield.
Yeah, exactly.
So, you won a belt since then.
Yeah,
since
yeah,
the
yeah.
Last time I talked to you.
Yeah, October 25th of 2019, I won the National Boxing Association belt. Then December 20, I did my first MMA fight. I won that one in 31 seconds. I knocked Buddy out.
Damn.
Yeah. And then January, I did 2 jiu-jitsu competitions. February, I'm going for the Guinness Book of World Records with combat sports, man. I'm trying to.
You just trying to do everything?
Everything.
What's your favorite so far?
I love boxing just because that's my original, my roots, you know. I love the bare knuckles, really the foundation of everything, you know.
But yeah, that was like the OG shit.
Exactly, yeah.
Like that's not, that's like 1800s.
Exactly. This guy right here, John Sullivan, is actually, he's like the first champion ever in bare knuckle fighting.
How many rounds would they go back in the day? Or were they pretty quick like this?
I think back in the day was different, a little more savage than it is now, you know. Now it's a little more...
They're worried about concussions.
Exactly. Back then, I don't think they had anybody standing by the ring just in case you got knocked out. This time now, it's 5 rounds, 2 minutes each, so it's a 10-minute fight, which is really, I mean, you know, you think about it, it's quick, but in 10 minutes, a lot of shit could go down.
How much did he land anything on you? Did he land any shots?
No, he got one hit. Because he was trying to wrestle me the whole time. That happens a lot when you put hands on people, they try to hold you.
Grab you.
Exactly. And he hit me one time on the side of the head, nothing crazy. I didn't feel it, so honestly, like the next day, I went to chew on something. I'm like, damn, what the fuck is this?
Well, you was talking, last time you were talking about getting hit with a beer bottle and didn't realize
it. Yeah, exactly.
Until you were covered with blood.
Yeah, you know when you got that adrenaline pumping, you don't feel none of that shit.
All right, let me take a look at it. Is there a sound on? Let me check this out.
Not on that one.
All right, let's see.
It's quick.
You don't want no piece of that.
Yeah, that's somebody watching on their TV.
Oh, damn, he caught. Damn, you caught him.
Yeah. Right there, his nose was leaking like a faucet. He was
blood all over the place.
Yeah, there was blood everywhere.
That's when he grabbed you. He was like, hold on for one more day.
Yeah.
That's ballsy, dude.
Right here. Ooh.
Do you think this is going to be the next thing in fighting?
Guaranteed it is. Guaranteed it is. BKFC is huge. It's like the UFC for bare knuckle. There's celebrities in the crowd. The shit's growing. I mean, I don't know. I would say, like, I know they compared it to, like, how UFC was going, and this is probably, like, 10 times faster. It's on, it came out on Forbes magazine as, like, the next billion-dollar business. Yeah, David Feldman, which is a CEO, is running a great promotion. You know, he's treating fighters right. He's paying them right. He's got the whole media behind him. So, he's doing a good job about it.
Yeah, that's cool. Yeah. I feel like UFC really fucked themselves by, like, they're behind, like, this, some paywall with ESPN. It's like, I'm a casual fan, and I can't even fucking follow that shit anymore. So it's just like,
yeah, I mean obviously ESPN is, like, you know, the, I mean, yeah, not ESPN, sorry, UFC is, like, the, you know, the major leagues for fighting, especially here. But I don't know. I'm honestly trying to get in there myself, tell you the truth. Before the end of the year, I would love to fight for UFC too.
So, well, I think you have a good chance since you're whooping everyone's ass.
Yeah, that's what we're going for.
I want to see him in my corner. I'll tag him in.
Yeah, yeah. That's going to be my next venture, too. I'm calling out everybody in WWE, man. Let's get it.
Hell yeah. You start doing, yeah. Right? Hell, you're just everywhere.
Yeah, yeah. That'd be dope. We and Dana start the first co-ed match, you know what I mean?
Dana, how long you been wrestling for?
6 years, yep.
For real?
Yeah, long time.
What's your special move?
It's a senton off the top rope. I go on the top rope and do a front flip and land on the girl.
Bam.
Yeah.
Hell yeah.
I was a gymnast for 18 years, so I'm trying to take, like, my, you know, athletic ability into the ring and flip them around. Also, strength is my, you know, I dominate in strength too. So picking girls over my head and slamming them out in front of me. I mean, I could have broke the little Barbie doll that was sitting here. Yeah.
That'd have been awesome if you did. She could have got a GoFundMe.
Right.
You would have done her a favor doing that shit.
Right, right.
She finally would have got her fucking GoFundMe money.
Yes, I could have saved her virginity.
Nah, you know what would have fucking happened? She would have tried to sue everybody here for $500,000.
Right.
Yeah, I know. I know. Don't we got a waiver or anything like that? How come, you know, my dream always was, and they don't even do it. I always wanted to be a manager for WWF.
Who would you manage?
I don't care. I would just go and shit on the. I would be a bad
you
guy's
have the,
manager.
You have the gift of gab, huh?
Yeah, I just want to go out there and just shit
you
on
know
the crowd.
Who Paul Heyman is?
Paul Heyman?
Yeah.
Nope, but yes.
I think you two could go back and forth real good. Yeah. Yeah. Spitting that.
Yeah, I just want to go out there and fucking.
You could be my manager, our manager. I want to be
like Ric Flair. Woo! Yeah. Woo! Jet flying, Rolex wearing.
Yeah. Yeah. I want to be like the new Bobby Heenan. You know what I mean? Like, just fucking talk hella shit. That's wrestling's probably more popular than ever too, huh?
It is
crushing.
It's worldwide.
Yeah.
Vince McMahon is one smart man. I mean, he's amazing. You know, we have Raw and SmackDown, but they're two different brands now on two different networks. Raw is on USA, and SmackDown just got moved to Fox. And he just, you know, started up the XFL, which is huge. It's kicking off. I mean, he has his hands in everything. Smart man.
You know, Vince, like, wrestling's like a cult. You know what I mean? I've been following around since the 70s. People have been following us around. Vince got an empire now, you know?
So what's the difference between the SmackDown and the Raw?
It's just literally, I mean, they're treating it as like, we have drafts, right? So the whole brand or the whole WWE is under one roof. But, you know, we sit there and then we get drafted to different shows. When I first started, it was Raw and SmackDown. All the talent was on Raw and all the talent was on SmackDown. So we would travel all the time. Our schedules were super busy. And then, you know, Vince wanted some competition, you know, with in between splitting the brands, Raw and SmackDown. I bled red, which is Raw, for my entire career until recently when SmackDown went to Fox. And it's, for me personally, it was like a refreshing start for my career. I got on my own and just took off, and it's been a blessing. Truly has been a blessing. And we were just here. We had the SmackDown premiere in LA at the Staples Center back in October.
How'd y'all two meet?
Through mutual friends. You really want to know?
Yeah, the story is I had.
Oh, let him tell first.
Y'all right? Be having muscly sex.
Right. I was just right. Put you in a hole real quick.
I jump off the top rope on her ass.
Right. That bed's our ring, right?
So before my last fight, you know, I was training with Yoel Romero. Shout out to Yoel. He's coming up for a UFC belt fight now in March. It's gonna be huge. But she was in town. They were mutual friends. He was talking to her on FaceTime. And he gives me the phone, tells me to tell her how to get to where we're at. So I get on the phone. I'm like, hey, look, this is where we at. She said she fell in love when she seen me on the FaceTime.
Yeah. Slid in that DM real quick.
Hell no. And the rest is we're here talking about it. You know?
Right, right. It's funny. Because, I mean, we just vibe, right? I give his lifestyle. He gets my lifestyle. It's good. We train together. We're on the same page. You know, we get each other. So it's easy. It's fun. I was telling him in the room earlier, I go, hey, listen, I know a takedown for you to do. So, try and show him a thing or two. He shows me how to ground him, you know, on the girls, ground and pound and all that stuff. Sounds kind of bad. But
I know how to ground and pound on girls.
Yeah. Yeah. Hell yeah. Yeah. No, but
no safety words, nothing.
Yeah, right. Yeah, exactly. Right. No, everything's working out great, man. We're taking it one day at a time and everything's cool. You know, with our careers, everything works out great.
Who travels more? You then?
She definitely does. Yeah,
definitely. I'm gone. Every week. We have shows every, for me on SmackDown, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, sometimes Sunday. So we're wrestling 4 times a week. I get home and I just try and train and recover my body. The traveling is super demanding. We're on the road, you know, from one town to the next. Flights every day or travel. We go overseas and we're overseas on tour 2 to 3 weeks at a time. Honestly, it's been the best decision of my life is to join the WWE because it gives me a platform, right? It gives me the freedom to go out there and speak to everybody and try and inspire people around the world to never be complacent because I feel like people are always stuck and they don't ever want to get out, right? And with him, too, it's like he's in 4 combat sports. People only stick to one, right? They never want to step out of their comfort zone. And Yuli does. I mean, bare knuckle, you have to. I always say this, and we talked about this the other day. There has to be a little crazy in us to do what we do and wake up every single morning knowing we're going to get kicked, punched in the face.
I know when you sent me the bare knuckle thing to post, I was like, didn't this motherfucker just win a goddamn, didn't he just win a belt?
Right?
Like, now he's bare knuckle fighting? Yeah. Like, what the fuck? Yeah. He's out his goddamn hookup.
Yeah, man. In the last 5 months, I've done 4 combat sports. I did boxing, MMA, boxing, October. Now, in May, December, in January, I did the 2 jiu-jitsu competitions. February, we just did bare knuckle.
What do you find most challenging? Is it the jiu-jitsu or the MMA? Or
you know, MMA is more challenging just because it's a bunch of shit you got to do together. You know what I mean? It's all different types of training and with different coaches. It's definitely more demanding. But I love it overall because I feel like that makes me better all around.
Right.
Like I told my coach, but once I got back to boxing, I'm like, this shit's easy. When after leaving MMA, this shit's easy. You know, my condition is up. You know, you hit from different angles. I love it, man. You know, and like I said, like bare knuckles, taking it back to the roots. I just love fighting. I went to prison for fighting on the street. Now I'm getting paychecks for doing the same shit. You know what I mean? So it's amazing.
And sometimes you take your fucking what makes you bad and you turn into your gift.
Exactly. That's what's happening now, and it's really amazing, man, to be on that card. I was with Hector Lombard as the main event. I did it. It was in South Florida for the first time in 100-something years. Like, it was, I was on pay-per-view. It was like, man, it's a dream come true, brother.
What was it for? What was the MMA thing you were fighting with?
No, MMA, oh. I fought, that was the bare knuckle thing I was talking
about. The bare knuckle was Hector?
Yeah, Hector Lombard was the main event.
All right, bet.
Yeah. The MMA was in December. That was on UFC Fight Pass. That was seen in 130 countries. That's another huge accomplishment.
You had like the top 10.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I had number 9 knockout of the year for Titan FC. So
pull that shit up. Let me see. I want to see.
Yeah.
That was quick too, right? Yeah, how long
Titan
was
FC
it?
Top 10 knockouts.
So wait, how long you been doing jiu-jitsu for now?
Since December.
Jesus fucking Christ.
I started December right before Christmas. I did my first competition January 11th. I took second place. Then 2 weeks later, I did my second one January 25th, and I took second place in that one too.
Some people are just natural ass whoopers.
I was just, you took the words right out of my mouth.
You know what it is? I mean, I'm saying what it is for me, but it's like, you know what? I think everybody gets that little bit of like nervousness of like you fear the unknown or whatever. But I feel once you get past that, and getting past that is like actually stepping in there, doing whatever needs to be done. Either you get your ass whooped or you whoop some ass. And once you get out of there, you're like, holy shit, it's this feeling of accomplishment. That's great. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And that's what the high is for me, is that feeling of accomplishment. Because before it, yeah, and like I said, at least for myself, you're like, you know, a million things go through your head. Even Mike Tyson said it. He said he saw himself getting knocked out every time before the fight, you know?
Yeah.
And once you get in there, you do what you got to do, and you step out of it. Like, it's such a huge sense of accomplishment. And that's what I feel now. I feel, you know, great, especially coming from all the bullshit I came from before. It's huge for me.
That's fucking awesome. 888-742-3345. Let's go to Paul in Jersey City.
Hey, how you doing? Hey, so I wanted a quick question to ask you, Yuli.
Yes,
did you have any experience with the Cuban wrestling program when you were back in Cuba?
No. I was actually born and raised in Miami. I don't have any experience with the Cuban team. The only experience I have with that was wrestling with Yoel Romero and Hector Lombard.
What's Cuban wrestling?
Cuban wrestling is Olympic team for Cuba. Those guys are known worldwide for
savage.
Savage. Yoel comes from that school. It's savage.
So they're really good.
Yeah, top of best
in the world. What you're trying to say is
so best in the world, they were at a certain point.
888-742-3345. Armando, go ahead.
Yuli, what's up?
What's good, Armando?
Lady, it's Mandy.
Mandy, go hola.
Mandy boy, chilling, dog. I'm proud of you, dog. I'm glad to see you kicking everybody's ass out there, dog. Stay up.
Thank you, my brother. I appreciate you, man. Love.
Stay up, champ. Team Thank Monster. You. Lale, man.
Thank
love.
Love.
Ray in Phoenix.
Yo, Yuli, what's good, big dog?
What's good, pimp?
No, man. Just want to stop forever fans out here, homie. Just keep doing your thing. We back you up 100%, dog.
Man,
keep
thank you.
Keep smashing them, and we're going to keep hollering for you.
Thank you, man. I truly appreciate that. Thank you.
Yeah, big ups, dog.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
So with all these different fights that you have, like most fighters, they wait, like 6-8 months between fights. Is are you worried about wearing yourself down too quickly?
I'm not at all. I feel great, brother. I feel great. You know what I mean? And let me tell you something. I appreciate you having me on here. This makes me feel good. It makes me feel like I'm doing the right thing. These people calling in from all types of different states that I don't even know are looking at me.
Right.
Makes me feel good. Makes me keep going. I feel super healthy. So as long as I'm healthy, I'm ready to, like, I said 2020, I'm taking no breaks. So far, January, I did jiu-jitsu. February has been bare knuckle. In March, we're trying to set up a boxing match. April, I got an MMA fight.
Straight
I'm
up.
Just keep rolling, you know? I mean.
Ribbon dancing.
Yeah.
Fucking July and shit.
Right. Yeah.
You know, we got plans. Hopefully by summertime, I'm in WWE flying off the ropes on somebody's ass, you know what I mean? But I feel great. I feel healthy. God willing, I stay healthy, and I'm gonna keep doing this thing, man. You know,
what's that? I love watching wrestling documentaries, and it like wrestlers just take fucking ass whoopings.
Yeah.
How do you recover? What's your body feel like?
Honestly, I just listen to my body too. If you know, some days I'll train intense in the gym, lift super heavy, because fitness was my background. I competed in professional fitness competition, so that's kind of where my mind escapes, and I go in the gym, lift heavy shit, move around, but sometimes my body just can't handle it, right? So I'll take a day off. I just listen to my body, and then I love to get in the ring and just kind of roll around and train and do new things. We have a huge training facility in Orlando, Florida, so I live down in Orlando and kind of, you know, perfected the craft there. But wrestling, you're always learning, right? There's psychology behind everything that you possibly do, but ice baths, recover, massage, chiropractors, and you know, I'm fortunate enough that my best friend, she's a massage therapist, so anytime I feel like a little, like last week I came home and I couldn't even walk, like I landed wrong or something like that, and I just had to take some time off for myself and get worked on. Ice is my best friend, but the medical staff and team with WWE is the cream of the crop. You know, we have the best medical team around, so they take really good care of us within the business. But yeah, you know, talking to a lot of the guys from before, as you said, from documentaries in the past, Ric Flair, Undertaker, Stone Cold Steve Austin. I mean, I don't know how they did it. You know, with the technology back then compared to what we have now, I mean, it's unbelievable.
Their technology was opiates.
Yeah.
That was their technology was cocaine and opiates.
But it's amazing to see them backstage and telling us their stories about when they used to wrestle and on the road all the time. And I was, you know, blessed enough to step in the foot in the ring with Ric Flair. That was my huge first storyline. I dressed up as Ric Flair, came out the gate, made a distraction and learned to become the dirtiest female player of the game, you know. So he taught me his ways. He taught me his tricks. I used to cheat all the time to help his daughter win. Charlotte Flair, who, you know, she's going to headline WrestleMania again here in April, which is in Tampa, Florida. So that's really exciting, too. So. And Yuli's coming. He's going to be there.
WrestleMania.
Yeah.
I'm trying to make my debut WrestleMania.
Yo, Yuli, if I see your ass start wrestling too, I'm like, this motherfucker.
He was on the Super Bowl commercial.
He
was on the Super Bowl commercial?
Yeah, the one with J-Lo, Khaled, and Pitbull. You see it?
Right?
I'm the one that threw the football and knocked Khaled off the...
Bro, I got to tell you, I drank so much G, I was like, I was nodding at the fucking table.
I had a string of drool from you.
Oh, bro, I was like, oh, this is a good game. I kept drinking G, and then the next thing I know, I was really fucked up. I was like...
Game was over.
Yeah, I made myself go throw up like 3 times. I was like, just keep it together, Judy.
Right.
Yeah, beginning of January, Pitt called me like a... midnight.
Yeah.
He's like, hey, listen, we're filming a Super Bowl commercial tomorrow. I want you to come with me. I'm like, all right. Next day he picked me up and it was me, him, Khaled, J-Lo, and I think they told me Kareem Abdul-Jabbar was there. I didn't see him, but that's what they told me he was there. It was a badass commercial. And it was a commercial. It wasn't for a brand. It was an actual Super Bowl commercial that led into the halftime show.
That's fucking dope. Yeah.
It was great. Yeah.
And Pitt, so I'm sitting there with Pitt. Pitt throws me a football and tells me, hey, Monster, show him how we doing the 305. And I launch it's a football. It looks like right here. All right. Looks like a pineapple, but it was a football I was throwing. Oh, and it was directed by Michael Bay, dog. It was wild.
There goes J-Lo putting on her
She's
stuff.
She's life goals. J-Lo's bling cup. Gotcha. Hey! Whoa!
Hey! Whoa! What's wrong with that cup?
Are you gonna get him?
I'm not going down on that.
He's the hero in this.
I got this. There.
She can't get me.
So wait, like, where are you
here
at?
It is. What, right what, here. Right here.
I gotta go harder, J-Lo's fast.
Okay. Yo, Pitt, help me out.
More throw. Show them how we do it in the 305.
Oh, there you go. Did you just hit him with a pineapple?
Yeah.
hell yeah, cuz.
Yeah, dog.
That's fucking awesome.
Thank you, my brother. Thank you, man. Yeah, I've been getting blessed with these opportunities, man.
Well, you know what? You've been grinding for these opportunities. You know what I mean? Like, no one gave you shit. You went out there and got it. So it's like, it's good to see you out there doing that shit.
Thank you. Thank you. I've been working my ass off and people are noticing. So, yeah. Thank you.
All right. So your next fight is going to be?
As of right now, we got him scheduled. I haven't signed no contract, but it's say March 31st. It's going to be down in Miami.
And that's MMA?
No, that's boxing.
Boxing.
That's boxing, yeah.
You can be defending the title?
Yeah, I'm going to be defending that title. Yes, sir. My first title defense. So I'm looking forward to that. And keep track, man, because I don't even know what I'm doing next. So much fighting I got going on.
I think once you get your fucking all that jiu-jitsu and all that shit down, you're going to be MMA is going to be like.
Yeah, that's what I'm going for. Right now, the only reason I'm not training is obviously because I'm here. But when I get back to Miami, I'm going full-fledged with everything. With everything, I'm just, whether it's a boxing match or an MMA match, I'm getting ready for like everything, whatever comes. So whenever they call me, I'm ready.
Yeah. Yeah,
that's my new drug, bro. It's getting working out. Working
Mine's
out
GHB.
That's new for you.
Well, it's it's constant though. Yeah,
I think I remember they used to sell that shit in fucking GNC and shit back in the day.
Yeah, I got some right there.
Yeah, I love LA.
The best part is I'll have it in my 5-hour, and I'll be like, oh, that's awful for you. You shouldn't drink 5-hour and
you're like,
drink.
Dink.
I'll be like, oh, no, it's GHB. They're like, oh, that's cool.
Yeah, makes it okay.
Yeah, make sure you don't drink the 5-hour.
Right. Yeah, just you can drink that floor cleaner, but don't drink that five-hour energy drink. No,
they
sir.
They used to sell that
Bob.
Shit in supplement stores. Like, it was like a workout.
Yeah, they do.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. It was until, in the 90s. Yeah.
Until people found that it's like a rape date drug. It's a date rape drug.
You know, I never did that shit because I saved up my money working as a bathroom attendant at the gay bar, and the gay dudes loved that shit. And every now and again, they'd be like, they'd be buff as hell, and like they'd be fucking G'd out, like wah, wah, like baby pterodactyls coming in that bitch, like and convulsing and shit. I'm like, what the fuck is he on there? Like, oh, he's G'd out.
G'd out.
I'm like, shit, I'm staying away from that. And then the Russian homie gave me some like 20 years later. I'm like, hey, not bad. Pretty fucking good, these gay guys.
That's just like liquid Xanax and shit, ain't it?
Yeah, it's pretty chill. Yeah. It makes you want to like fucking eat and bang. Yeah, that's the goodness. Well, I really appreciate y'all coming through. It's fucking awesome,
man. Thank I appreciate you, brother. Thank you for the opportunity. Quick shout out to my management team, Game Time Management, my people down in Miami. I love y'all. Everybody keeping up with me. Thank you. I appreciate y'all. And stay tuned.
You can follow him at Yuli_Monster and Dana Brooke. Your shit is long as hell.
Asha Sabera _Dana Brooke. You can find me there. Next time we're in town in L.A., I want you to come through.
Hell yeah. Now I want to meet who I got to talk to be a fucking manager.
I know someone that knows someone.
I want to bring managing back. I want to come out there and shit on every
I'm going to put you on my team, man. You're part of Game Time Management, man. I got
like,
you.
Fuck you peasants. Hey, whatever.
You should walk him out for his next fight.
That'll be dope, man. Yeah. That'll be dope.
Get out there and just talk shit to all the fucking toothless rednecks.
Fuck yeah, shit is wild. That shit ain't nothing like a fight crowd, bro. And bare knuckle crowd, that's like a fucking, that's wild.
Yeah.
That motherfuckers don't give a
it's
shit.
It's like a splash.
Oh, I ain't gonna talk shit to them, bro. I'm talking shit to wrestling people. Where they know it's a joke.
Yeah, right?
Hey, let me tell you, they're wild too. She took me to Royal Rumble in Houston, Texas.
Yeah.
44,000 people out there, bro. It's wild as shit. Wow, I'm talking about grown ass men with their little belts on their shit.
Yeah,
it's
bro.
Fun. Out, it's so much out the fun. Way. It's like family events, but all these people, I mean, they get really into it, and feed off of.
They got a cult following. Sorry to interrupt.
Oh, no, you're
but
fine.
They got a cult following, bro. This thing is bigger than anything. You know what I mean?
I know shit. This has been going on since we've been little. You know what I mean? Exactly. It just keeps going and going and going. So. Congrats to both of y'all.
Thank you.
And can't wait to see your next fucking fight, bro.
You know, I always send you them text messages, bro. I appreciate you.
All right, let's get it.
Yes, sir.
All right, don't go anywhere. We got news coming up next.
And now, it's time for News from the Chin with John Z. Matthews.
Looks like there are 9 types of vaginas.
I feel like this should be let's just have this be a 2-part series.
We can do that.
Because that's a lot of pussy.
That's a lot of vagina to
fucking
cover.
Nine. Like, that is a fucking, that can even be a 3-part series. Like 3 a day.
How many have you seen?
I don't know. I don't.
More than a couple hundred.
Yeah, I don't know. I've seen a lot of pussies. Yeah. Seen deep pussies. Shallow pussies, wide pussies, narrow pussies, stanky pussies.
Was there ever a vagina you didn't like? Where you just said, I can't do that again?
There's been a couple. Sometimes they're like rough on the inside. It's rough pussies. It's like gravel. All bumpy and shit.
Some sort of condition?
I don't know what the fuck it is.
Oh boy.
I didn't bring it up.
Doesn't sound good.
Fucking a bag of unpopped popcorn or some shit, like popcorn kernels. Oh,
what are they, pimples?
No, it's just like, I don't know, man. Just textured. You think it'd be better, but I like a nice smooth pussy.
Well, they're looking at the outside pretty much.
Oh, all right.
So, basically, asymmetrical inner lips. Having these lips basically just means one of your labia minora is bigger than the other.
Who the fuck pays attention to that shit?
Well, I mean, I guess.
Like, how much bigger is it?
Well, there it looks like a deformity.
Does it look like LL Cool J's pants like back in the day? When he used to wear like one sweatpant up and the other one down? I can't see none of the pussy. Oh, yeah. It's like the bike messenger pants. The pussy's like one's way up, one's way down. I haven't seen that.
No.
If I have, it's subtle. You know what I mean?
Yeah, this looks like a deformity.
All right, give me another pussy.
All right, so the curved outer lips, nicknamed the horseshoe, because outer lips curve into a horseshoe shape, and if you stand in front of the mirror, you have the vagina. The flaps make a window at the top, so you can normally see the clitoris. What?
All right, I guess.
Have you ever seen a horseshoe?
Jesus Christ, dude. We're just running out of shit now, dude. This is ridiculous. Okay.
Look like two girls are trying. It's like you're trying to pinch with your fingers. That's what it looks like.
It looks like the fucking Batman. It looks like the Penguin's hands.
Oh yeah.
It does, right? Danny DeVito. Like I'm gonna get a hand job from Danny DeVito. What's this one?
Prominent inner lips, and often the outer lips will be parted because the labia minora extends further than the labia majora.
I see that. That's pretty common.
And look at that. This was the most common type of vagina that she saw.
There you go. I called it.
When was the last time you saw that one?
I don't keep track of pussies. Right. I just go down there and get after it. The thing I notice the most is if it's hard to get to the clit. Because when you're eating pussy, like that's where you want to be at. And if it's hard to get to the clit, man, you're really fucking. That's half the fucking battle. That buried clit, or it'll be really small and have the flap over top of it. So you gotta like pull up and spread it apart and really get there. Oof.
So also work. Prominent outer lips, and it means your labia, they're puffy and enlarged.
Hey, nice fat pussy. I like that.
Puffy.
Mm-hmm. Like that puff, like it got a bee sting.
Is that a good thing?
I don't know, just like a fat pussy.
This one looks a little unusual. Long, dangling outer lips.
I've seen that before.
How often do you come across piercings on a woman's vagina? And that would be a good one for a piercing there.
I don't know, one in 50 or some shit. Yeah. Which I'm happy about. I just don't understand it. I'm like, all right, sweet.
Well, we can continue this because this goes on. There's a lot of vagina to look at. A
lot of pussies out there.
I'll put that back in the file.
Thanks, lady, for writing about all those different pussies. It's the inside that matters. All that shit on the outside don't matter. It's the inside. Can you take the dick? There's a hug, shit like that. Get wet.
Yeah.
I don't give a fuck about the lips.
It helps. So the kids, they are doing this skull breaker challenge.
And what?
Like the name suggests, these kids are getting fucked up.
Wait, the skull breaker challenge?
Well, you'll see it.
What are they doing?
Three people stand side by side, and the kid in the middle, he jumps up, and then his friends then kick his legs out, so his head slams the ground. Thereby breaking his skull.
Yo, I posted some shit like that. I didn't realize that was a challenge. It was like fat people. It was like one fat person jumped, and the other fat person jumped, and then the fat person in the middle jumped, and they kicked their legs out from underneath them. But I don't think the person in the middle was in on that shit.
It doesn't sound like it.
So, all right, show this to me. Jesus Christ, dude.
Man.
All right, so.
Uno, dos, tres.
Oh!
Uno, dos, tres.
Oh, shit. Oh, that's his head hitting the ground. Oh, fuck me, dude.
Why am I laughing? This is horrendous.
Do they know that they're in the challenge? Are they like, okay, man, we're gonna do the challenge, or is it like, all right, let's see how high they're gonna or how high we can jump?
It seems like it. So we've got another one here.
All right,
and again, it doesn't look pleasant.
It's brother with the new rag. Oh, fuck me.
Ha-ha.
He's knocked out. That motherfucker's not. He's sleeping. Now they're trying to drag his ass. Yo, that's a good idea. Hey, drag him. He's knocked out. Drag him around the floor. That shit looks like a setup, bro. Because they're like, hey, let's see how high you can jump. I'll jump. You jump. And then they kick.
I guess that could be true. I
mean, that's what it looks like to me. They're like, hey, let's see how high we can jump. I posted that shit. I didn't know that was a challenge. That's some shit like you would want to fight somebody off of afterwards. Like, bro, like, once I stop being concussed.
Well.
That's like hit you in the face with a hammer shit. Like, come back. That's not even like fair fight. Like, bro, you just, what the fuck was that?
And of course, some parents are online saying that they had to take their kids to the hospital with, of course, head injuries.
Yeah.
Their heads are smacking the pavement.
Yeah, dude. Motherfuckers can, like, you can get brain damage off of that shit.
Do you think that guy's really knocked out? He sure.
Yeah, that motherfucker is asleep.
Yeah.
Don't do it again,
no,
dog.
No, I just
Jesus fucking Christ. Yeah, he's asleep, bro. And it's all, yo, how come every time you see a motherfucker get knocked out, it's always someone's like, is trying to pull them up. It's like, yo, dude, just let them fucking, make sure they're not swallowing their tongue. Put them on their side or some shit like that and just let them sleep for a minute till they wake their asses up. Like, all right, man, come on, wake up. Tap their cheek or some shit. They're always trying to drag their asses up.
Well, I think that guy's hurt.
That's a that was a dumb challenge.
We will not be doing this.
Nah, bro, shit.
This is not happening.
All right, now I'm cold in here. Fucking, now I'm fucking freezing.
Oh, that's right. I gotta fix that.
Nah, I was like, yo, Chris, can you turn down? It was hot and hot as hell, and now I'm cold once again. All right, what else?
All right, so thanks to social media, breaking up is more painful than ever before. I believe it.
Oh, yeah. I've been that guy. Going on your ex's fucking social media page.
It's fucking terrible.
Seeing what a great time they're having.
Why do I do that to myself? Oh, look. There she is. She looks so hot with her new guy. It's fucking terrible. It's fucking terrible.
The only good thing about that shit for me is I feel like I'm still superior to their new bows.
I guess.
I'm like, psh. Look at that fucking cornball. But still, even so, you're just still like, oh, god damn. Look at them having fucking fun.
Oh.
Oh, they're in Acapulco. I'm sitting here jerking off in my bedroom. Looking spun out on acid, 4 a.m.
Jeez. Yeah, some
it's
ladies.
Dark.
Some lady's new guy even friended me, so I friended him back. I was like, what the fuck?
Why'd he friend you?
I don't fucking know. And then, so suddenly, I friended him back, and the next day, suddenly, I'm just seeing shots of them together, and I was like, no.
No, I'm not.
Beat it.
Yeah.
Sorry, man.
Mute. We're still friends. Mute. Don't need to see that shit.
That's right, the mute.
Yeah, just mute the motherfuckers.
Yeah. Okay. It's like getting punched in the face.
That's the mute's the good one, man. See, you just fucking, oh, yeah, I'm still following you. You're just muted.
And if you have too much to drink, then you can go there on purpose. But you're not going to get slapped in the face on the bus.
Nah, I don't. Yeah, I don't look. There's nothing good ever comes of looking at your ex's social media. Unless they're in total shambles. And then you could be like, ha, 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 ha. They got like 3 kids by 3 different dudes and shit. You're like, yeah, bitch, look at you, rat. Fucking rat. I was right to leave you. I knew it. can't believe I fucking put my dick in you.
That's an upside I hadn't thought about.
Yeah, but.
And I'm guessing you don't spend much time on Facebook, but they have this take a break feature that allows you to hide the ex's activity. And so when you change your relationship status to single, then you can do that.
Oh, that's cool.
Block people out. Take a break.
Take a break. There it is. Yeah. Yeah, social media. Ugh.
Yeah, especially after drinking. It's just not a good thing. It's
terrible. I know. Every time I'll be like high as hell on some drug, I'll be like, oh, I'll be fine. Let me look at this shit. And then you're like, you're not fine. Nope. And then you mix that with the come down too the next day. So you're like already super depressed just from like the lack of serotonin and shit. And you start thinking about life and life decisions. Bad news. Bad news.
I'm just starting to feel bad now. All right.
I'm like all right with myself because like, you know, there's a reason why you're usually exes with your ex. You know, there's a reason. So like you come to terms with that shit.
Yeah. One thing that I've done in the past is that if I'm feeling particularly sort of sour about it, then I'm like, wait a minute, all this bad shit that led to it. And I have to refresh my memory like, oh yeah, that, all this other crazy shit that went down. Seems to help.
Or I'll just look at who they're with right now and like how happy they are with them. And I'll be like, that motherfucker's corny as hell. So it's just like, that it was never meant to be.
Yeah.
Like if they were that happy with, a cornball like that, then, like, you know, they got a little corny in their system.
I think that's a fact.
That's the way I look at shit.
So these ring bells and Nest cameras.
Dude's got like a tribal tattoo, you know what I'm saying? Like, or what, you know, whatever. Fuck. Guy goes to Agape there, whatever that weird fucking church is over there. You're like, come on, man. The church that came up with the secret. You're like, he goes to the secret church. Give me a fucking break. You don't feel so bad.
So these Ring and Nest cameras that are all over the place now, and they really are.
I
see them all over now. It's very disturbing. And this is now normalizing surveillance. And so let's say you've got this in your house and suddenly you're watching the kids. Some person I know was house sitting and then she was getting calls. But hey, you know, the cat's food's getting a little low. And then it's like, holy shit. I mean, they're just monitoring.
They're watching?
Yeah, they're watching. And she was sleeping there. I was like, get the fuck out of there. She's watching you. It's fucking terrible.
That's fucking weird, dog.
Yeah. I wouldn't want to do that.
I put fucking towels over every goddamn camera. Like, nah, man. I'll watch your house, but you ain't finna watch me. The cat's food's getting kind of low?
Yeah.
How much were they paying her?
Not much.
Nah.
Yeah.
Fuck. Like, nah, bro. You know. Let's get a couple things straight. You ain't finna be watching me while I'm fucking watching your house.
Can't have you watch me jerk off on the couch. And again, if you've got these, lock them down. Before I came in, I just did a quick scan around, pulled some up for you. It's just so fucking easy to find these cameras that are.
Yeah, you could watch anybody.
Yeah.
That's why I don't have that shit, man.
It's a nice little neighborhood there.
John's literally going through people's fucking webcam shits. He's just clicking up, and that's a desk, and someone's foosball. No one's playing it. They're probably at work right now. You can go over there and steal their foosball. Hey, there's a couple guys wakeboarding, just fucking chilling.
Oh, that's what that is. Okay. I thought they were scientists or something, but no.
You thought they were scientists of what? Were they? What kind of scientists is that?
I thought they were trying to find some fish, save the fish.
All right.
I don't know.
Yeah. That's why you're not the head producer. Fucking ideas like that.
But yes, you will never get a camera in your house, I'm thinking.
No, they already got me on lock with my goddamn camera phone. Like, I'm already being bugged, but let's just try to keep this to the minimal.
And, of course, a bunch of people are now partnering with cops so that the cops can dip in and out of your feed. Of course, there has to be some level of protection, but they're linked to a network, so if I work there, I can figure out, like, oh, let me just go check out half a dozen houses right now. Just, that's no problem.
Dog. This is like the safest we've ever been. This is the safest we've ever been. And you're like, fucking, you're teaming up with cops.
Yeah, that's wild.
Like, there's certain parts of the world where motherfuckers will go kidnap you and make you their wife and shit. You know what I mean? Like, right now, they'll just go to some other tribe and just snatch you up and fucking kidnap you and rape you until you're married. And we're over here fucking freaking out. Afraid someone's gonna steal our PS4. So you're letting the cops watch your shit. Fuck that, dog. No way, man. No fucking way. Not a chance.
It looks like 900 police agencies across 44 states are doing this. So it's all over the place. I'm sure it's happening here in LA. Of course it is.
Yeah.
Of course it is.
Man. We're just... It's crazy watching this shit happen faster and faster and faster. Like, can you imagine within the next 10 years? Like, this is nuts right now. Within the next 10 years, there's already words that you can't say. Like, your language is being... Like, when I post shit on fucking Instagram, they'll be like, are you sure you want to say that? Like, Instagram will come on and ask me if I'm sure I want to say what I'm saying. I'm like, what? Like, yeah, and then I'll retype it, and they're like, are you sure you want to say that? I'm like, damn, dog. Like, that's right now, they're fucking...
Can you give me an example of what that would be like?
I was like, don't go out like a bitch or some shit like that. And they're like, things like this often get reported. Are you sure you want to say this?
Oh.
And I'll be like, I'll try to spell bitch in a weird way, and then they'll fucking be like... Things like this often, I'm like, God damn. That's just Instagram. They got motherfucking cops watching everything.
Well, they're just trying to help you out.
They're just trying to fucking control my speech. Ugh. And it's not even context, you know what I'm saying? It's just like.
Are you still shadow banned?
Yes, but not yet. Yeah, but like not. Yeah, I'm still shadow banned. Yes, I am.
I thought you had a plan. There was some sort of theory that you were trying to.
I gotta fucking, to get unshadow banned, I tried it once. I gotta change all my passwords and fucking disconnect everything. I did that shit and it didn't work, but maybe I did it wrong or something. I don't know.
I don't know if you take many naps, but you shouldn't ignore the benefits of napping. A new study, 2,000 people, discovered that these nappers are more likely to identify as productive people, and the non-nappers did not identify as terribly productive, but it sort of reinvigorates you. You ever take a nap during the day?
No, but I need to. I wish they had little nap pod. No, I was just going to say, I wish they had nap pods here, but you would just fucking jerk off in them.
It's not impossible. We're taking a nap in here?
I'm sure you have. Back in the day when I worked at Sirius in New York, I would sleep underneath the desk because I come in there at work and shit and then like knock out a bunch of stuff and then take like a half hour nap and then start the show. And people would talk shit. I'm like, yo, dude, like, I'm over here handling stuff. Like, fuck you.
He's under the desk.
My desk. Take a quick disco nap. Really helps.
Yeah, does it clear up your hangover? Let's say you're a little...
Yeah, just like, look, man. Like, just if you can just shut down for 20 minutes, half hour, boom, reinvigorates you.
Check it out in the office. Your office. Nice couches in there.
Now you sleep there.
I've done that.
Yeah, don't.
I know. But it's on the weekend.
Stay out.
There's nobody around. Stay away.
Yeah, but I just don't want your fucking germs on it.
Germs.
I don't want the John germs.
I use a t-shirt as a pillow.
Dog, no. Right. I literally came in there to fucking use my shit. Your fucking boxing gloves and shit are fucking all over the fucking office, man. It's fucking gross, dude.
All right. Well, there's no, like, drying underwear in there or anything.
That's your bar? That's what you set your bar at, not drying underwear. Your fucking disgusting ass boxing gloves are on the seat where people fucking sit.
All right, put them on the floor.
I had to roll up a fucking piece of paper and like hit them off because they're just this. They look like some crusty. They look like crusty, like mummified shits you'd find from Egypt. They was like all crusty and fucking hard and shit.
Oh, those are the wraps. Yeah, those are pretty grimy.
Yeah, and you just had them. Those. Yeah, you just fucking put them where fucking people sit.
Those get wet.
You're an inconsiderate asshole,
There's
dog.
There's nobody around.
It doesn't fucking matter. Someone's got to sit there sooner or later, dude. There's nobody around. Not your office, bro.
All right.
My office. Got you got it. A desk. Go put your fucking disgusting shit there and then find another place to sleep.
Kane's a germaphobe. We'll see.
Kenan's a germaphobe. Leave Kenan the fuck out of this. You got your fucking boxing gloves are in the fuck in there.
They could be there today. I'll take care of it.
Yeah, they're there every fucking day.
I got it.
I feel like you'd be like passive aggressively doing shit.
It's not passive aggressive. It's just a place.
You're like, eh, fuck him. Let's yell at me. Let's yell at me. I'll put my fucking sweaty ass jerk off hand gloves on his seat.
I wash him once a week or something.
Yeah. All right, man. Well, you got some good news?
And now, time for good news.
I've got a taxi driver here in California, and he saved an elderly woman from being scammed out of $25,000.
Damn, how'd he do that?
So, she was in his cab, and then she said that she needed to go to the bank to withdraw $25,000. And that's because she got a call saying that she owed the IRS money, so she was going to withdraw this cash. And he said, whoa, 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 whoa. And she didn't really believe him. So then he took her to a police station, and they said, yeah, the police don't give this strange man $25,000. So she dodged that bullet.
It's crazy. Like, old people really trust fucking the system. They're like, oh, well, the IRS said so I better fucking go do it. And then they go do it.
Yeah, contractors coming in to scam my mom.
It's fucking
Fuck
sucks.
You.
I know. Some mechanic that be doing my granddad like that. And it's just like, we try to tell him, you know what I mean? We're like, yo, dog, quit going to this fucking dude. He keeps doing work on a car that doesn't need to have work done to it. Like, he's just running up your shit. But it's between the two of them. What do I do? Hey, stay away from my grandpa. My grandpa's gonna still go there anyway. Like,
you can go there and get a look at death.
Can't do shit. I ain't gonna do a fucking thing. I don't even live out there. If my granddad gets one more thing, and then what if he really does need a repair? Then what? I don't know. But he be tacking shit on like a motherfucker, dog.
Oh yeah.
They be getting old people.
Well, this taxi guy, Rajbir Singh.
He's like,
he saved the day.
He's like, bitch, is you crazy? I just got here. I know that's bullshit. My cousin run that scam. My family, we run that scam. You bullshit. That's bullshit. Shout out to him. Saved her 25 racks. Them old people, they got money, man. They just be sitting on that shit.
My God, I mean, for her to suddenly say, oh yeah, this sounds legit, let me withdraw $25,000. Be some guy just asked for it on the phone.
I told you my homegirls, my grandma, same shit. The Cholos got her for 10 racks with the goddamn fucking kidnapping shit. We kidnapped your daughter or granddaughter. You got to give us money, da da da. And the worst part was she damn near had a fucking heart attack. You know what I mean? She's like freaking out like that. She was going to fuck around and die from like just the trauma of thinking of her kid getting fucking, her grandkid getting fucking stole.
Yeah.
But yeah, they got her.
You have to be a real dick to go after an elderly person like that.
These motherfuckers, they are fucking dead broke in another fucking country. Like...
Yeah.
Like, fuck that shit. They out there shitting in the street, man. They hungry. They're like, fuck these motherfuckers. Let me get that fucking money. They hungry, bro. I'm not even mad at them for trying to do that shit. Like, yo, bro, if I was fucking dead broke in some fucking shithole ass country, I'd be doing the same shit, calling up over here to America, like, yo, hey, man, shit's fucking, yo, we kidnapped your granddaughter and you owe money to the IRS.
A twofer.
Yeah, I'm trying to get all the money. Send me a bunch of goddamn Apple gift cards. ASAP. Stat.
Well, not if Raj Beer is around.
Raj fucking was like, nah, I got you, old lady. Shout out to him. All right, that's the news. All right, that was the show. I want to thank Heidi Pandora at Heidi with the H-E-I-D-Y dot Pandora. That's her socials. And Ulysses the Monster at Uly, U-L-Y underscore monster. All right. You can also follow at the Chris Carlin, all C's. At John Z. Matthews at All Out Show. At hit up, I always forget Keenan's.
Carlo Keens, C-O-L-O-K-E-E-N.
There it is. Bam. And me at One More Jew. Those are the Instagrams. Don't go nowhere. There's more All Out Show. Or, well, no, there isn't any more All Out Show, but there's more Shade 45 to come. All right, let's go.